I'd have known you had a storm to weather. So before you go.
Hey there, Ben and Katie here to tell you about our wrestling podcast, Kinda Fun.
About 10 years ago, I got obsessed with the world of wrestling, and I started working on television shows and documentaries about it. Before I knew it, I was an insider getting all the latest gossip and kayfabe from behind the ropes.
And I'm a super fan who needs the latest gossip.
And I've got deets and important news coming from my favorite cuties.
Katie, you're the only person who would call these bruisers cute.
They are, and I love them.
So mark out with us.
Tap the button to start listening to Kinda Fun free, only on Spotify.
At Fry's, we know there's never a good time to run out of fresh. Luckily, our delivery and free pickup make it easy to grab what you need. So whether it's a few extra buns for the backyard barbecue or some miscellaneous munchies for movie night, we make it easy to get back to doing, well, whatever you were doing. Fry's, fresh for everyone.
We're here to help you save on the food and essentials you need. Just buy 5 or more participating sale items and you'll save $1 each with card. Fry's, fresh for everyone.
GEICO has the insurance industry-leading app that lets you manage your policy anytime, anywhere, which means that GEICO is always there for you. If only everyone was always there for you. Like animal control, when you're cornered in your garage by an angry possum.
Hi, me again. You guys said you would be here about an hour ago, and I think the possum is starting to get angry. Listen, I thought if I fed it, it would go away, but now it is ripping holes in the drywall and making some sort of nest. Just call me back.
GEICO, always there for you with savings and the industry-leading mobile app.
What's wrong? You've been asking, but I don't have an answer. How come I'm still thinking? Let's pretend to fall asleep now. When we get old, will we regret this? Too young to think about all that shit. And stalling only goes so far when you've got a head start. 'Cause we could stay at home and watch the sunset, but I get up from asking, are you bored yet? And if you're feeling lonely, you should tell me before this ends up as another memory. Will you tell the truth so I don't have to lie? Will you tell the truth so I don't have to lie?
I don't know where we're going, but I like to. make you stay. But you're savage love. Did somebody break your heart? Looking like an angel, but you're savage love. When you kiss me, I know you don't get to. But I still want that. You're savage love. You're savage love, love, love. Spend up all my cash every night and every day. I try to make you stay, but you're savage love. Did somebody break your heart? Looking like an angel, but you're savage love. When you kiss me, I know you don't get to, but I still want that. You're savage love. You're savage, la, la, la. You're savage, la, la, la. You could use me, cause I still want that. You're savage, la.
We're gonna get started here in just a couple minutes, everybody. I'm sharing live into our Facebook group, and we have Brian already on the horn here, so sit tight, we're gonna be starting soon.
Whom he may
devour.
Ronnie J, please turn me up.
Back to the little boom, way, what's up, boom? Take some rain, no song, rain on one more. Rain come, come shine, come rain, good man. South side, let it bang. Outside, let it rain.
All right, everybody, welcome to today's shareholder meeting for the week. This is our June sales meeting. Yes, I know it's July, of course, but we're going to honor all those for your sales awards for June. And we're excited, and with no further ado, really, I'm not going to take much time here. We're going to go right into things with Brian Erhahon. Brian, we're so excited to have you. Thank you for taking time. I know this is a different time for us than what we normally go live with. We normally are at 12:30. So we got people that are dropping in. We're live in our Facebook group, but I'm going to turn everything over to you because I can't wait for us to have this conversation about falling back in love with real estate. So Brian, take it away. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Let me just get my Zoom rookie card up there. I was on mute for a second. How's everybody doing today? You know, Jason, I appreciate you, man, for bringing this dialogue to your group. I'm 100% grateful. And, I'll tell you, man, what you're doing for your group is not often seen around the country. I think there's a premium on leadership right now. And I love to, I regularly start that dialogue off because I think that every community, every business owner, obviously real estate practitioner has leadership in their toolkit. And I believe that that's something that we're making sure that we remind ourselves daily is, how am I showing up as a better leader today? So I trust that helps there. So again, leadership is at a premium, and Jason, appreciate what you're doing, man, for your group.
Thank you.
And let's keep it going, shall we? And I trust that, you know, I know we've got some folks on the call or dialogue, and yeah, let's get it going. And I was thinking of this, you know, yesterweeks now, because we've been working on this dialogue for some time, and I find that, you know, hey, what is it that we could talk about that would move our agents and market centers forward versus the standard bold conversation? And yes, I'm a bold coach and MAPS 101 coach and former team leader for 4 years. And this is not another sign up for bold dialogue. This is a remind yourself on why you jumped in this beautiful business called real estate dialogue. and all the perks. And I want to make sure that we're taking advantage of everything that we have to offer in this business as well as in this company. And if you might find that there's some things, oh, I forgot about that, or oh, I didn't know about that, right? And so we'll talk about that as we go through. We're going to talk leverage. We're going to talk systems. We're going to talk time blocking. We're going to talk lead generation, investing. So we've got a little bit of everything that we're going to discuss here today in a short amount of time. So as I eat into my own time here, let's get the dialogue going. So let's talk about that cost entry into this business here. Obviously, this is where we start. I actually had a dialogue with a gentleman. Just came off another session in another area, part of the country. And one of the agents pulled out a couple of conversations on this slide here. And one of the dialogues was, the question was, you know, hey, how do you see this slide? I mean, what pops up to you? And a gentleman ended up saying that, you know, the barrier to real estate, we've all heard this, needs to be higher. I mean, come on, for $2,500, where else can you go? It's kind of like you're taking $2,500. And I said, hey, the cost of to get in that real estate is like a bad night in Vegas, right? You lose $2,500 and then all of a sudden it's like, oh my gosh. That's a bad night.
For some people, that might be a good night in Vegas.
That might be a good night in Vegas. Exactly, right? It's relative. Success is relative for sure. And when we look at that, are we playing to the level of the business in the way that we invested?
You know, Brian, it's so true. And I don't want to keep interrupting
No, please.
You, of course.
I mean, but, appreciate the dialogue.
That most of the agents in our office know that I am also an attorney, my business partner and I. And that number, that's a legit number. That's a number that when I look at, it makes me cry, because I'm still paying that, even though I'm doing the same kind of thing y'all are doing. And man, the cost, when you look at the startup costs and the upside that's available in real estate, there's not another place that has such a strong upside. So true. Wait.
You're talking the upside here, and we see it. I mean, there's a stat out there. Again, this is all KW research, stat based, and obviously we don't put anything out as a company that's not backed by stats. And we know that the average salaried individual peaks in income at the average age of 45 to 49. So you're telling me that, you know, an average worker who's maybe been on the job for a while, they've been there, they're grown, they're bringing value to the company, and their income is peaked at that age of 45 to 49. I mean, how does that show up as fair? I mean, it is what it is. It's business. And guess what? Let's look at that orange line there, and we're talking real estate, right? You jump into another craft and master that craft, the craft that's yours, by the way. And we'll talk a little bit more about that. And I think where we typically go in, and another reason why we love this business, is that we get to slice up the pie how we want, right? We get to work how we choose. We choose to work in ways that, you know, for instance, there's a personality style. Every type of personality style in this business can earn a phenomenal living. This is not just for high drivers. This is not just for high influencers. This is not just for high analyticals. Every way, every type of business, every type of personality style and behavior has been successful in this business, right? Now, the caveat to that, though, and here's how most agents walk in, and I'm going to give you the solution to it. Most agents walk into this business saying, wow, they're making a pile of money doing online leads and paying Zillow a bunch of money. I guess that's what I'm going to do that, right? Or they're, you know, hey, they're making a ton of money hitting cold calls all day. I guess I'm going to do that. And then we come into this business and we jump on it and we don't show up as successful. And that's a whole be, do, achieve type of dialogue, by the way. And yet we don't show up as successful because we haven't mastered it or it hasn't come naturally. And we're not making the same money because we're judging our insides by other people's outsides, BOLA alert. And then we decide, you know what? Hey, maybe this business isn't for me. Or man, you're in real estate, go get a job, right? And then, or ooh, real estate, ouch. You know, hey, I did that years ago and I wasn't successful at it, so good luck. And yet we go off of other people, what we judge to be successful based off other people. And yet here's where the money lies, and here's the cream of the crop lies, is where you actually have the opportunity to choose how you intend to lead generate that matches with your personality style. Here's how that show up, meaning that if you are a high influencer and high, like bubbly type of, you love people, maybe you lead gen to events, right? Or maybe if you're high analytical, maybe you're lead generating through online leads because you can measure it, cost per click, cost per lead, cost per impression, right? And you can come up with more efficient ways to convert those leads. I know, I've done it, right? And so when you're talking about, you know, or you're a high driver and you're like, you know what, I gotta get there quick, all right? I gotta hit the phones, you know, I'm a smile and dial and make it happen. I've also done that. You're talking to a guy who used to talk to 70 expireds every single day to set two appointments, is that's what I did. And yet I'm the kind of person I thought to beat up my microwave to go quicker. And yet at the same time, you know, that's how we're showing up at, you know, is, are we at peace with the way that we prefer to work? And have we matched the type of lead generation necessary with the way that we prefer to work? And that's where most agents don't, you know, grow or are unsuccessful, is because lead generation is that, you know, it's that bland flavor at this point that you've been shoved, you know, here you go, here's another bite, Lord, lead gen, the answer is lead gen, the answer is lead gen, the answer is lead gen. And yet I get that. How are you doing in making sure that you actually are choosing a lead gen method that works? Right? Eat the veggies first. It's one of my rock lines. He's like, how do you want your bad news? Good news or bad news? And he says, you know, I like my dessert first. And so I say, eat the veggies first. Right.
I think that's so good, Brian, because people get so tired of hearing I'm supposed to lead gen. But lead gen is this massive gourmet smorgasbord, mm-hmm. and that also has a whole bunch of, you know, crap in it. So you have to be very clear with yourself as to what do you like. Yeah. And if you don't know what you like, then you need to go out there and you need to try a whole bunch of things, taste it, see what it's like, move on from it if it's not something that's your deal, and know that there's so many things out there that you can do to lead generate that to just be like, oh, I don't like to call, so I don't call, and so everything's off the table that requires calling. I'm just going to wait for stuff to show up. Mm-hmm. That's never going to get you moving forward. That is the definition of just, you're going to have a business by default, right? Yeah. Just whatever's going to happen, you're going to luck into it.
Get lucky.
So be clear about what you like, find what you like, and then go deep on that. Find the classes, the MAPS courses, mm-hmm. the trainings around that thing, and go very, very deep. And don't get distracted by, oh, well, this person over here seems to have some success on Instagram. I'd always like mm-hmm. to do Instagram, so I'm going to start doing Instagram. Wow, that's a great way to undo everything you've done.
Well, Jason, I mean, on to that note, I mean, take a list, right, of and note your strengths. Note those strengths as well as what you like to do, and see if you can come up with a pattern on what shows up for you and how you can lead generate potentially through that pattern that you found. I mean, This is a conversation of us of truly understanding ourselves inside. And, you know, for those of you who aren't aware about this, the core 6 personal perspectives, and we hit this home in bold regularly, well, bold 2.0 and now bold pivot, is that, you know, Gary Keller has never worked for anyone who wasn't a millionaire prior to starting Keller Williams. And so with that, he understood that that millionaires move in certain ways, have certain ways that they see things and certain ways that they approach obstacles. And he made a system around that called the 6 personal perspectives. That first part of that system is called the committing to self-mastery. And we've got to be at peace with the repetitious boredom that it takes for us to be a master of the skills that we're out there to jump on. And first, that means that we're having a dialogue with ourselves, understanding, okay, what do I like to do? What do I love to do? What am I good at? And truly master yourself internally. Lead yourself before you can lead others. Put your mask on first before you can assist and, you know, others with their mask, right? So, you know, when we're talking about, you know, the understanding of ourselves is self-mastery. We can't get over, let's not overlook the foundation of what it takes to be successful. Another reason why we love this business so much is obviously we get to choose our our calendar. I'm not working for you anymore because I want to choose my own hours. Guess what? No hours is not an option. Right. That they don't bring that as an option. Right. That's not on the test that you take, the exam that you took to be a realtor. Are you okay with no hours? No, you don't win off of that. And yet when we're talking about really truly building a business, and yet the contrary to that is, you know, long hours are not virtuous. So then we're also having a dialogue on, hey, are you saying, hey, I worked 12 hours yesterday, way to go. And you're right. And are we high-fiving on that? Or are you saying I put 4 to 5 hours of focused effort, focused lead gen, focused activity, and I'm getting more out of the day possible, right? It's more of the latter conversation. Right. And so when we're looking at how we prefer to work and we look at, you know, the successes that leave clues, you know, take a page out of, you know, Wendy Papasan's book, where you can truly build a business around this amazing, you know, career or industry where you're building a business around your priorities. Like for Wendy Papasan, who's a wife of Jay Papasan and a co-author of the Millionaire Real Estate Agent book, she was very clear in her first years where she was like, you know what, I'm a mom and a wife, and that's my priority. So I'm only going to work this business between the hours of 10 and 3. That's it. That's all I got. So, I mean, when we're looking at that dialogue, I mean, how focused do you think that she had to show up in order for us to run, for her to run her business? I mean, how focused do you think that she had to show up? That's a question. for anyone who wants to unmute themselves and share. How focused do you think that she had to show up personally to win and to sell 18 units her first year?
Come on, guys.
Hey, I'm at peace with awkward silence, too. Can't do this and not be okay with silence.
I mean, that's it, especially on Zoom.
I like saying the awkward things at times. You know, I usually get some good faces to go along with it. Right? How might she have had to shown up in order to win at a high level in her business to sell 18 units? Oh, by the way, sell 18 units her first year and fast forward 10 years later, close out $100 million in production.
Yeah. You know, when I remember when Wendy started talking about getting in because Jay was talking about it. Mm-hmm. And their first couple of years, she was just, you know, was regular producing agent, but mm-hmm. that focused effort, guys, what would your business look like if you took that type of focus to your business? If instead of working that 8 hours, you had this laser focused 4 hours, 5 hour business that you were working on, because obviously she was super focused in those, yeah. in that time that she had and has become super successful. But what happens in your business? What would you have to change? What distractions would you have to eliminate to allow you to have that sort of laser focus? Because we're all capable of it. It's just, it's a skill. It's just, what would you have to do? And what would your business look like if you did that?
I mean, Jason, I think you've talked about the principle before where we fill our schedule or our cup or whatever we're doing with what we're allotted. So mm-hmm. if we're allotting ourselves less time, we're going to be more focused and trim the fat, and we're going to do the things that matter.
Mm-hmm. All work fills the time allowed, right? Bulldozer.
Yep. We will expand to that time that you're given. And yep. people always wonder, well, I go on vacation. Why did everything all of a sudden, like everything starts going crazy? Well, it's because you forced yourself, knowingly or not, to be a little bit more focused, and just that ratcheting up just a teeny bit cause those changes.
Totally. I mean, you're so right, and that's so good. And when we talk about, you know, what is the top 20% that our agents or our top agents are doing to call themselves successful every single day, do we have a very clear picture of how we are winning every single day? Do we know what winning looks like? Because when you come into this business and we're like, okay, well, I get to determine how I succeed, right? And actually just gone through it recently and stepping out of the team leader role in December and jumping back into production and, you know, coaching as well for my personal business. It's kind of like, huh, I got all this extra time now. Oh, what do I, right? I had to go back to what, how do I consider winning? And so if we don't have that definition, we'll just take anything. And that definition, you know, by the way, if you want it, it's having a planner. And it's, in case we didn't have enough acronyms in Keller Williams, here's another one for you. And yet we've got, right, you know, the prospecting, right? That top five, prospecting, planner, P, prospecting, lead follow-up, appointments, negotiate, and then role play, scripts, right? That's the top five things that we could do if we did every single day, such that by doing it would move our business forward. I mean, what opportunities couldn't we jump on if we just focus on lead gen every single day, right? What investment properties couldn't we buy if we focus on those top five every single day, right? It's a plan R, right? PLANR. Mm-hmm. So, you know, when we have in that dialogue and as we transition to the investment conversation, you know, I look at the different industries and we look in and kind of compare, most people compare the real estate industry to the financial sector, in which it's a good comparison. And yet in the financial sector, I mean, aren't people getting locked up for insider trading? Isn't that a thing, Jason?
Totally.
Yeah. I mean, just ask Martha Stewart. She was successful at that, right? No judgment. And yet, you know, what did she really do? Really? She took information that wasn't readily available, acting on it and built wealth and then got locked up. Didn't hurt anyone, and yet took information that was, now that's the, according to the standards of our financial sector, right? And keep people from getting over on others. And yet at the same time, we're looking at real estate. We don't have that law. As long as we disclose, and we make it equitable and it makes sense for the sellers by disclosing, and it's a win-win all around, could we create investment opportunities for ourselves? Right? And so I got my attorney, Jason, on the line in case I misstep here. So, Jason, I'm about to run, brother. I'm about to run. So when we're talking about investing, could we go and build our own iBuyer platform? Because Gary Keller talks about regularly where, you know, most agents will go out there and focus on getting a listing and go out and find a buyer for that listing versus going out and finding a partner to buy that listing with. Well, hey, I don't have the money. I don't have the money to make that work. And yeah, you show me the deal, I'll show you the money.
Yeah, the thing to do is
yes, I did a little Jerry Maguire there. Right? Yeah, Jason, what were you going to say? What were you going to say? Show me the money, Jason.
It's changing the question to how. How do I do that?
Yes.
And as soon as you change that question to how do I do it, not that I can't do it, just say how do I do it. There are actually, guys, you know, iBuyers aren't in every market. Mm-hmm. But there are agents showing up in every market, bringing the iBuyer to those places, and they're, of course, making themselves the opportunity because of exactly what you're talking about there, Brian. And that's throughout Keller Williams. When I go to Gary's, you know, I'm in Gary's top 200, and when I go in those meetings, there's several people. When is Keller Offers coming here, and how can I work with them? And they're not like, oh, this is a problem. It's how do I change it? How do I create an opportunity when I want these different things to happen? Mm-hmm. Chelsea, did you have something?
No.
Is a strategic unmute. And so, you know, and here's the thing, you know, Jason, I wanted to touch on that because, you know, when you're talking about iBuyers and whatnot, I mean, let's look at the stats. 90% of iBuyer inquiries are selling within 12 months. 90%, 60% are seller listings within that same time period. So when we're talking about what lead generation looks like in the future, and I believe it's around the iBuyer conversation, because they're dumping billions of dollars of marketing and resources and all of the above into the mindset of the consumer. And here's the thing, if you haven't heard about an iBuyer in your market yet, that may be for a couple of reasons. Either that they haven't shown up, or they're just not marketing to you. They're marketing to your database.
Yeah. And that's the thing here. You know, we being Phoenix are that hotbed. You know, iBuyers mm-hmm. were here before they went anywhere else. OfferPad's home base is here, for Pete's sake.
Home base. All right. So, I mean, I trust that you've already, you know, created that presentation to address the dialogue early and often. Right. Yeah. And I trust that we've already put that together where, you know, if you're not addressing it in that initial pre-listing conversation or our listing packet and or presentation and asking the seller, hey, have you considered selling off market or selling direct to an investor because it makes more sense to you? Have you considered that? Because if we haven't addressed that and we don't get the listing that day because, you know, whatever the scenarios and we didn't address that conversation, and then you follow up a day or two or a week later and you find that they've sold to an iBuyer, is because we didn't address that dialogue. Yeah. We're past the time of winging it in this industry. And all this says, and all the stat of 90% of sellers who inquire, who are acting on iBuyers, is because they want three things. They want transparency, they want options, and they want convenience.
Yes.
And if you're not touching the base on any one of those things, especially the convenience side, especially of what does it take to sell in a COVID type of market where you don't have people tracing through your property, you don't have to keep it showing ready, you don't have to put on market time just to potentially fall out of escrow because somebody lost their job due to COVID, right, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And yet there's so many reasons why this iBuyer entity or focus checks the box for so many sellers or potential sellers is because of it's more convenient. And yet, are we addressing that? And by the way, could we go to our own investors and say, hey, investor, if I were able to find you a property that's off market 80%, 80% of dollar and had net cash flows and has a 12 to 15% ROI annualized rate of return, would you buy it? And obviously, they're going to say yes. They're going to say yes, right? Or they're going to say, hey, well, how about these metrics? Let's iron out the metrics first for our iBuyers, because the great thing of working with investors is it's not about the house, it's about the numbers. And if you make the numbers match up and you show them the money, they'll act on it. Now, here's where we go. Could we take it a step further and build our own personal wealth by saying and sacrificing our cash flow today, being our commission, and saying, hey, investor, if I were to get you that property at 80% of the dollar and the cash flows for an annual rate of return for 12 to 15%, and if I put in my commission into the pot, would you make me a partner? right? And you disclose, and you make sure that your attorney, Jason, checks off on it, right? And your seller's good with it, like, because you disclose. Could you bank more wealth for yourself and your family and make your clients happy at the same time? Right? Could you go to Keller Inc. and be in mastery around this dialogue and go to Keller Inc. under resources for the millionaire real estate investor and download an investor workshop, right? Kit, and that comes complete with a PowerPoint and a handout, and start to do your presentations and build partners via your SOI and bringing that webinar or session to them regularly, right? Could you do that? Right, these are all phenomenal things and ideas that we can do to create a community of investor-focused dialogue. Because here's the thing, what happens when you have 5, 10, 15, 20 people every single year that said and are committed to buying one home every single year? Are you changing the direction of their lives, as well as are you making and changing the game for your lead generation? Because now it's not about you, you have buyers and you have buyer partners. Now it's about you out there going hunting for those sellers who are off market. Now we've made lead gen fun, because now it's not a who do you know that wants to sell. It's who do you know that wants to sell off market, because we have offers ready to go. Again, these are just ideas.
They're great ideas too. And isn't essentially what you have right there on the screen, the iBuyer? The iBuyer is going to list it. And they're saying, well, should I buy this property or not? And that's really all they're doing. And you we as the agents, we have such the inside track on that. Why is that not more often seen as something we add to our own arsenal? Great question.
Chelsea, I love what you're saying there. Double dip. You caught my eye at double dip. That's where you had me, right? And we're talking about, you know, being able to work smarter. Love that. Great aha. Nikki, yes. Yeah, present. Hey, Gary Keller once said, and Nikki, you were jogging my memory there. Gary Keller once said, the best salespeople are educators first. Ooh-wee. Best salespeople are educators first. How are we doing
for at sure.
Educating our businesses, our business owners? Nikki, what else do you have to say?
I just agree 100%. I mean, that's what we do, right? We consult and we educate. So I love that you're bringing that back up, because honestly, I haven't heard about it in a couple of years. It's just a great nugget. We used to have, you know, 7-8 years ago, we had agents when the millionaire real estate investor first came out for 10 years ago. That's exactly what they were doing. They bought the books. They had seminars in our university room. And you know what? Now I think you could absolutely do it remotely, and you may even get more because do it in the evening and have people sit at home.
Yes.
And jump on, you know, and go ahead and go through the seminar. And they have the seminar created for you. So I just think that was a huge aha and reminder that that's a tool we have, Brian. So I appreciate that.
Let's just say, you know, with doing just that and doing a seminar once a month from the start of my relaunching of my personal business to now, I've raised almost $500,000 in capital with investor partners who are ready to go out there, buy, right, rehab and rent and refi, right? That BRRR method, right? And so, you know, those are all things that we, you know, that we know works. Again, Zoom and this whole COVID thing has sped up the focus on us being digitally based and physically enhanced. So can you transact more digitally because of what the times that we're in? So just ask my wife. She's getting 10 buyer contracts a month by just doing 2 buyer consultations. Now they're more, instead of consultations, she's doing more webinars. And so these webinars, she's packing in a bunch of people, and her lead gen is literally, hey, who do you know that wants to enjoy or take part in a wealth building conversation about homeownership that we could include in this discussion? And literally, she's getting invites and referrals for that we're rewarding, by the way. Right? We reward the referral, and yet we're building that pipeline. We go out there, we do the assessment, the webinar, and then her follow-up is literally following up with people who attended the webinar. So it's lead gen to the webinar and follow up after with everybody that attended and didn't. That's it. Keep it simple. You're going to see a theme in this kind of the dialogue today is about keeping it simple. Because here's the thing. I mean, is student loan an issue? Right? Student loan, this epidemic of student loans and debt is an issue. And so how are we doing in educating our SOIs and our homeowners that we know of and telling them about this issue right here and saying, hey, who do you know? Could you go out there and buy an investment property for every small kid that you have, stick a renter in it, and then fast forward 5, 10, 15, 20 years, is that their wealth base for going to school or starting a business or their next home to move into, right? Those are all things that we consider and we could look at. And I got that from Gene Rivers, like the kiddie condo idea. It's just buying a condo for every kid or an investment property for every kid that you have, stick a renter in it, cash flow it, and then make sure that it, you keep it over time. And all of a sudden you've got your seed capital right there for school, for business, for whatever it is, for life start. And when we look at the average net worth of a renter being $5,200 compared to that of a homeowner being $240,000 for a 45 times net worth difference, people are living through what you do, what you offer. And are we seeing ourselves as that on-ramp for other people's successes being that real estate vehicle that we drive? Are we seeing ourselves with that? Because there's a whole segment out there called aspirational TV. And if you don't know, a great conversation about that or subject of that is HGTV. Right? Looking at all these great, nice, big homes, love it or list it, property brothers and blah, 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 blah. Right. And kind of, right. And that's the fascination I have with this. I have no words. I just have a lot. Right. And yet people are living through you and through us and what we do as an industry. Can we use that to our advantage and say, hey, I am that educator that is the consultant for you building wealth. Cause here's the thing is IRA is going to do it. Self-directed? No, probably not if you didn't start when you're 20. How about 401ks, right? How about your pension plans if those exist anymore, right? What's going to do it? What's going to set you up and our clients up for a great retirement? And I don't do okay or subpar retirements. What does great look like? And how do we envision that and get into the consultative approach? Because now we're not talking about, hey, who do you know I want to buy? Which is a transactional conversation, going to who do you know that wants to build wealth, which is a consultative conversation like Nikki talked about. And so what are we doing to continue to bring that, I think maybe it's just bring that dialogue and keep the dialogue moving forward. We got a little bit of heavy there, so I'm going to back up off the pedal, and I want to see who, you know, what ahas we have or
dialogue. Like, you're heavy
about this. Nikki, what you got?
We like your passion. That's all. We like your passion.
You know, this soapbox is getting pretty high. I'm standing real tall right now. And so when we're talking about this, this is a great reason to love our industry. What you think, Nikki?
Well, I think that once again, I love that you brought up doing an investor seminar, but what a killer idea, and keep it simple. Let's get back to just regular Zoom seminars. You know, we kind of seminared it out for a while, right? But now I'm looking at this market. And this may be the best market ever to be doing remote seminars, because people are sitting at their house.
Yes.
This campaign, you know, boost some seminar ads on Facebook and Instagram, and you will probably have people show up because they're not doing anything else. They're not leaving their house. I think it's brilliant, Brian.
I'm just saying, I mean, this whole challenge that we're having, and if you're not getting better in these times, so that way you can thrive after this thing, I mean, I don't know what else you're doing, because there's no new TV on anyway. There's no sports. Like, what are you watching? What are you doing? This is about mastering our craft.
I love it. And that's something that ultimately you can pivot if you know, down the market it changes and you see that you're not getting the attendance that you were typically seeing, or it just becomes a pillar in your business and you just perfect it and you perfect the system about the lead generation system and the lead conversion system. So I love it.
Totally agree. I mean, thank you for that. And I appreciate those nuggets and those ahas as you share and unpack it for us, because you know, it's, you know, are we able to love what we do? And when we take ownership of the fact that we sell wealth, I mean, what else is there to talk about? I mean, we sell wealth. And when you have that understanding of, man, I sell wealth, do you get offended when people say, hey, I'm not going to buy a home today or this year? Like, I mean, that's the point that I think we should take it. Like, what? You're not going to buy a property? What do you mean? Right? Take offense to it, because you're talking about record low interest rates. You're talking about, I mean, awesome opportunities to finance. You're talking about, I mean, appreciation happening the way that it is. It's just, real estate is that perfect storm. And plus, there's never been more money sitting on the sidelines at any point in history than today. Where you're talking about equity built up in properties. You're talking about cash on the sidelines and people with money who are figuring out, saying, I want to invest it in something and I don't know where to invest it in because the stocks are too volatile for me. And yet, who can I go to that can help me create wealth with this money that I've got? Because my money's burning up because of inflation.
Yeah.
My bank's not paying me money. Actually, matter of fact, my bank's charging me money to hold my money there. I don't know. We got a little heavy there, so I think we changed it up a little bit. So who did this? All right, who took this listing and didn't warn us? This is a real-life listing, by the way. Right? Who did this? Wallpaper on the ceiling and on the back of the door and a matching couch to boot? I mean,
looks like wallpaper on the couch.
Yeah, it's one of our listings. This is real life MLS, by the way. Here's another one. This is that conversation where we're talking about, you know, your inner Rachel Ray or Emerald, right? You love to cook and entertain at the same time. Want your cooking show. You can interview your guests and stir the eggs at the same time. You're not missing a beat. So this is amazing, amazing listing. Love that. Real life listing, by the way. But this is my favorite one. I call this one the pit stop, right? This is it's when you couldn't make it up all the way to the stairs. To relieve yourself, so you have to, you know, build in a little added value there. Comes with the view. Again, these are all I kind of just live to do these presentations and then just watch the faces on this picture alone. This made my day, so I appreciate
that. One's amazing.
Yeah, right. Oh
my gosh.
All right, so let's talk business. Let's talk leverage. Let's talk making money. I think Jason, I'm talking to you, my man. I mean, you see it where I think we get into this industry and we say, you know, huh? I figured it out, coach. I figured it out, Jason. I don't need to do any of this coaching and training. I know how to sell property. I take listings. I help buyers. And that's where we stop as an agent, right? We forget that there's a whole second half of that. That's a salesperson or independent salesperson practice where it's I'm doing everything. And yet, what does it mean to be a business owner? Right, the type of business owner where you can be anywhere in the world and your business continues to grow and sell, take listings and purchase property. Right. So when we're talking about this simple process of delegation, yes, please take note of this slide. Make it yours, put it on your wall and make it simple, because it doesn't get any more simple than this. Where else can you go in this industry where you can go from an independent salesperson to a true business owner? And we live that model through career visioning. If you've ever been, it's the conversation of I do it, and then we do it, and then they do it, and then it's theirs. I'm gonna walk you through that. This is where you come into this business and it's all I. I do the lead gen, I take the listings, I work the buyers, I do the admin, until I've earned the right and afforded the ability to buy my time back in the realm of an administrative personnel, right? Buying that 30 to 40 hours back, meaning now we are doing it, right? We're taking on the systems, we're implementing, we're taking the listings and putting the listings on the MLS. We're doing it, right? And then they are handling it. And then from the we, because they're in self-mastery, they go from we to they. Now they got it. And so now you've just afforded your time back in the 30 to 40 hours. Now you're going to spend that on lead gen, or you're taking half of that and putting it back into the family, right? Whatever that looks like, you get to choose how you divvy up that time. And yet guess what? You bought the time back with administrative leverage. And so when we're talking about going from we, right? So you brought the assistant in and now you're in we for a short time, because it's about 90 to 120 days it takes for them to be really in their mode, right? So they got it. And then you go from they to there. The there is the sweet spot where you've got a person in your business that owns the role. They own the tasks, meaning Jason, get out of my way. You're holding me back. Go out in there and take more listings, so that way I can, you know, do my administrative role and we can all win at a higher level, right? That's where you have that all-star on your team that's saying, hey, get out of the way, right? Go set the screen, you know, go run the route, whatever that looks like. That's the their mode. What happens in your world, in your business, where you have enough sellable listings and enough people in their mode? Like, what can't you do in your business? Because that's how we go from admin to next thing you leverage out is your sales, your showing assistant, right? To buyer's agent. And then you leverage out the listings with the listings agent, right? A listing agent. And then you hire out the last thing that goes is the lead gen. And so when we're looking at that dialogue of, and now, by the way, this is not a salesperson conversation. This is a business owner conversation. We're talking business. We're talking big business, because you're talking leadership in that mix. You're talking leverage in that mix. You're talking delegation in that mix, right? You're talking, P&L. I trust that you have somebody that you're hired. You're watching the profit and loss statement because you're looking at your books to see if you're getting a return on that investment. We're talking investments here. We're talking business. And when we're talking about how we grow a big business and we look at this phenomenal blueprint, it's a blueprint, by the way, not a book. This is a blueprint that we go back to regularly and we revisit and we say, okay, well, how am I doing in my org model? How am I doing in my economic model, my lead gen? How are we doing with that? Because when we master this thing, This allows us to be a franchise within a franchise.
Yeah. You know, can you speak really quickly to, I love this, how it shows how simple it is. And it's, these are the steps you do. What I see so often is I'm going to skip a couple steps.
Yes.
The thing I really don't like is lead gen. So I'm going to find a way, I'm going to get fancy in my business, and I'm going to find a way to leverage that off first. Or I'm going to overuse this word talent, and I'm going to hire someone who is talent because I liked them. So I'm going to label them as talent. But true talent only shows up when they're doing what you said. Give me that and get out of my way.
Yeah.
Right.
That is the true sign of having someone who's talent. And we will skip waiting for that person to hire out of pain, and we'll skip the steps to hire out the lead generation because we don't want to do it.
Yeah.
What happens when you get fancy like that, Brian? What do you see?
Oh, burnout. And we'll talk about it. I got some slides to address it. And yeah, we'll talk about burnout, resignation. You hit a lid, you say it doesn't work, right? Because you got entrepreneurial and you just kind of winged it. And by, you know, you say it doesn't work, and then all of a sudden you're out of the business because, you know what, that thing, it didn't work. Or I choose to say solo because, now, no judgment, no judgment. If you do 10 units a year and it's hitting your goals,
right,
keep going. That's great, right. Job. If you're doing 10 units a month and you're hitting your goals, great job. Keep going. And so I don't want to misconstrue that this is a dialogue of, if you're not a team or a business or blah, 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 that you're wrong. There is no wrong in this business. It's your makeup. You get to choose. And yet, if you have the desire to grow this, say, craft and grow into this craft as big as, and make it as big as you want, then you're not skipping steps, because that creates more chaos and puts you more of a deeper hole than when you started. So, you know, it's like Jason, if you're going to be a part of, you've got a favorite sports team. I'm a Laker fan, so we're going to talk Lakers. Right. So if we're talking about, you know, you jumping on the Lakers being a championship level contenders that they are, would you be able to be on that team and not run the plays?
Not a chance.
Either you're going to get yourself benched or waived.
Waived, not even traded.
Right, not even traded. You're just going to get, right? Exactly. So, you know, why are we not running the plays within this business? By the way, if we were to, second part of that dialogue is, if we were to go to one of these top franchises and give them the average of the top 20, which is a 200 grand, and say, hey, here's 200 grand, give me a franchise, how well would you guard that money or that investment versus the bad night in Vegas money that we use to get into real estate being the $2,500? Right?
Yep.
2,500 versus 200. What kind of studious mindset are we bringing to the table when we have a $200,000 upfront invested into a franchise? By the way, let's look at it, Jason. Does this company offer how to hire? Is that a system that we offer?
Indeed.
Yes.
Right? When we're looking at the franchisor to franchisee relationship, what the franchisor is responsible for. So how to hire? Great. How about a system to manage my business in, or our version of a POS? Do we have something like that?
Yep.
Oh yeah, we probably call that command, right, Nikki?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Correct.
So then we're talking about, how about you know, a good reputable name that would allow us to actually attract clients with less effort. Do we have that?
Yes.
So then we are actually really talking about, we have the opportunity to truly have a franchise within a franchise. Whether you're talking about job descriptions, training modules, training systems, education, we're the number one education company across all industries worldwide, by the way. Like, they retired us because we were running up the score that bad. And yet when you're looking at what it is that we offer, I mean, are we taking advantage of the championship level playbook that we've got here as a company? Now, here's the thing. Why do we fall out of love with this business? And if I were to go right into that, it's because we say we don't know what to do. Jason, did we just talk about what to do?
We sure did.
Right? It's right here. Right? And so, by the way, we don't know how to do it. That's why we're a research-based company. Right, we're research-based, so we know that the average of our top agents are earning 80 to 90% of their business from just 3 to 5 sources. We know those stats. How are we doing it being? Now, there's this concept, Jason, that Gary talks about all the time, and yet the concept of being at peace with repetitious boredom.
Mm-hmm. The boredom, right,
of doing the same thing over and over, kind of like the boredom of being on a diet that causes us to eat a certain way, and you're eating the same thing over and over again. It's like, my taste buds desire variety. My friends, eat the veggies first, sauce it up however you like, spice it up however you like, and be at peace with the repetitious boredom of eating your veggies first. because eating the veggies first will allow you to grow a business to any size that would afford you to be anywhere you want and get your dessert later at any time in any proportion that you choose. I'm just saying. I don't know. Am I hungry? That's why I'm bringing up these. It's lunchtime over here, my man. Getting there. And so when we're talking about, you know, keeping it simple, there's a theme here. Let's keep it simple, right? Too much to do, too little time. If we're talking about time blocking and making sure we're putting the top 20% in, we talked about planner before, and yet one thing talks about the top three that we put into our calendar first. Who wants to go? Who's got it? What's the first thing that we put into our calendar first?
Y'all can use the chat too. He's watching the chat.
I'm watching the chat. And if you're personal on Facebook, you can type it in the comments, and yet you probably said time blocking your...
Here we go, Chelsea, answer, vacations. Answer.
Vacations, yes. Vacations, I love that. Good answer. All right, second.
Good answer, two, Chelsea.
What was that?
She said good answer, Chelsea.
Yeah, great, good answer, right? Five energy. Hey, Charles, you're talking about that energy plan. And at the back of the MREA, Millionaire Real Estate Agent, I love that. And yes, and that's where you keep your energy high, is in that one thing that you time block. Number two is time blocking your lead gen time. By the way, I'm a divert for a second, because lead gen comes in three parts, and yet we forget. And there's a fourth bonus part that we forget more oftentimes. And yet that first part of lead gen is our prep time. How are we doing, right? Prepping our call list. Second part is activity. Third part, we've got maintenance. How are we doing to make sure we're going back and developing our notes and our reminders and getting our clients back in connection with those vendors that they asked when we prospected to them, right? Whatever that looks like. And then the little bonus feature there, fourth part of lead generation, how about that follow-up? How many of us actually have follow-up time blocked into the calendar? Again,
we actually call it, you know, I've been calling it for years, lead jello for your generation and follow-up. You got to have some lead jello. Get in there and eat your lead jello.
Get at that lead jello, right? I love that. And the last thing that we put into our calendar is our planning time. When Gary Keller was asked at the top of the year, where do most agents fall off of starting the year with a bang? He says, you know what? It's not really a top of the year thing. It's more of a throughout the year thing is where we fail to plan, right? And we don't time block our planning time. And that's what we want to do, is have our planning time associated in that. And so if we're not time blocking our planning time, and how it might show up is, are you divvying up time to, like for me, it's every Sunday afternoon. Every Sunday afternoon, I'm looking at my 411, looking at what my goals were for the week I just came out of, and what my goals are for the following week, and aligning myself there, right? Right. So that's how it shows up. And so just keep it simple, because if we don't follow a plan, and we know that's why most agents fall out of love with this business, is by failure to follow the plan. Right. And look at what it says there. Number one, plans fail when they get overly complicated. Right. Complexity drives down our ability to implement. If you want to implement, increase your chances of execution, you keep things simple. Focus on growing the business and then running it. Right. Don't let your business run you. You know, run the business. And it's a conversation between proactive and being reactive. So overcommitted. So we don't prioritize. We don't say no. We don't delegate. We don't manage our expenses. Hey, guess what? I know that we actually cut our expenses early on in the year. And like we were instructed to do, all you heard was, you know, cut, 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 cut. And here's the thing. Great conversation with Jay Papasan when he was talking about being lean and leveraged. And I think it was in Think Like a CEO. And he talks about, you know, how we have an itemized list of our expenses, and taking that 12-month list and we break it down into three categories, or basically four categories. And first is that A list. That A list is the things that we can't do without. The B list are the things that we it'd be uncomfortable for us to work without. The C list would be the things that, you know, we're like, we don't need it anymore. And the D list is like, why do I have it? So here's the thing, why we continue to cut and revisit those expenses, because if you cut early in the year and you haven't cut since, here's a question for you. What you needed at the top of the year in January, do you need it right now? So for instance, Open Home Pro. If you were using Open Home Pro for your open houses as a lead capture, do you need that today? Probably not. How about Zoom? If you needed Zoom, if Zoom was a C-list expense at the top of the year, January, is Zoom a have to have in your business today?
Yes.
Probably, yeah, depending on the type of lead gen that you do. I could tell you it's a first off, right?
right after expenses, it's, you know, Zoom is an auto debit, right? It's got to, right, making sure that we have all the bells and whistles on that, because we have all these great capabilities with it. So measuring your business, because your business is always in ebbs and flows. You're constantly revisiting, changing, and evolving. And yet what you might have needed early on, you might not need today. Right. And so consider and revisit those expenses regularly. Obviously, we talk about the wrong people doing the wrong things. This is the leverage dialogue or leverage conversation. Poor hire, poor training, no standards, no accountability, right? Doing things that suck energy and working with people that suck energy.
So talk to the agent who doesn't have a team. What does this look like for them?
It looks like that client that you're afraid to fire. It looks like that client that you got to bust out the Tums or Pepto-Bismol for, because you get heartburn because they're calling you and you're like, why are they calling me? Right? That's what it looks like. It looks like that you maybe don't have a great lender, or you don't have a great a team member as a part of the team working, supporting you, or a support staff, right? It might show up with a bad credit repair person, right? So make sure that we have the right people doing the right things, and we're getting energy from doing the right things ourselves by loving the lead generation that we're doing, because we know that we're educating people. You see how we're connecting these dots? Right. And we're educating people, and we can let go or untether clients that are acting up and are choosing not to follow the playbook that causes success. And then we're replacing them with clients who are more excited about the opportunity to work with us. Again, you are the on-ramp for other people's successes to the investment opportunity called real estate. And you drive that vehicle. And so here's the thing. Another reason we fall out of love with this business is because we don't manage the health. Right. This is coming to you, Charlie, talking about the energy plan. This is right along with that: spiritual, physical, emotional, and then financial. So when we're talking about why we lose the fun, here it is. We don't keep the fun up with lead generation. Shocker. Right. We don't say we. Right. Yes, I did say we. Only way that I could say that is because I love what I do and I'll be passionate. I'm a grown man who just said we. Yes. Correct. Get over it. And yet I love what I do. And so when we're talking about what we love, what we do, yeah, are we connecting what we do with helping people? Secret sauce. Right. If you love Big Macs, you know that you love the secret sauce. Here's more secret sauce for you. And when we're talking about the why we choose to be more us, right, is I believe this is a conversation about giving up control, right? We want to look good and be right, and yet we become too attached to the job money versus actually delegating the jobs that we don't like or do well. Get out of the way. We're the bottleneck to the organic growth to our business. Get out of the way. Let your business grow. Right, good business is allowing your business to scale and then creating an environment that your business can scale with less effort. Right. So also second part of that, don't shoot the messenger. Right? We invest more in lifestyle instead of people or lead gen. Ouch. That's a real thing, by the way. That is a real thing. Right. So hey, by the way, if you were to say, hey Brian, everything else that you said today was garbage, trash, and it wasn't worth my time, I trust I'm able to bring it back with this slide here. Right, when we're talking to the top agents in our company, we're talking about the if you were to come into me and say, hey Brian, how do I get $2 million a year in my gross commission income? I would say get to your database to as quickly as possible is 14,000, and then the rest of the way market to them 36 times a year or 3 times a month. You get to 14,000 and you do the systematic communication, you'll get to that $2 million gross commission income over time. So when we're talking about and look at this. So, and Jason, I wanted to talk to you as the top performer here. How many agents have you come across outside of Keller Williams who are running their business now, probably successful agents in their own right, who don't have a database or a CRM? What's that percentage look like in your world?
Oh, it's stunning. For those that I come across, it's upwards of 80% that aren't running. I mean, and they'll say they have a database, but when you dig into it, find out what they actually mean by a database, they ain't got no database. Because when we say
spreadsheet or really kinda, nice cell phone.
Yeah, we mean a CRM with a database. When we say database, we're like, it's one thing, right? Because we understand that. But for them, it's like, yeah, I got a list of people. Yeah. That's my database. And no,
it's not.
Shocking how few do.
I mean, how else are you managing 484,000 touches, right? If you're looking at the size of your database times the average annual, right, then we're talking about the 484,000 touches there. How else are you managing that if not a system to approach it, if not a database, if not a command, right? So I've been over, 1,200 interviews in my time as a team leader, and I look at that and I say, 1,200 interviews with non-KW agents, a good amount of them being in market share and production. I mean, 90% of them, no kidding, Jason, did not have a database.
Yeah. Yeah, it's crazy.
Crazy. So if you heard that today and you said, man, if I wanted to be better than 90% of the competition out there, is just get your system plugged into command and start marketing to them systematically. That's it. If you want to be better than 90% of the competition out there. So as we wrap up today, we don't allow what we do to ever be enough, right? And that's the final slide there for that dialogue is, you know, be at peace with where you are. And at the same time, Gary Keller says, never settle, right? Never settle. Appreciate what you have and never settle. So with that, my question is to you. Hey guys, I'm exhausted. I'm tired. It's halfway through the year. I feel like I just ran two marathons and then some, and I'm exhausted. And I got it. I know that I have to keep going. I know I got to keep going because this is about my family. This is about who I'm doing it for. And I'm very well at peace with what I do and how I do it because I love what I do. And I'm willing to put in the time. I'm willing to continue to burn the candle on both ends. And yet, if we have ever been disconnected or challenged with the industry, you know, probably now is the time to be that with it. And that's okay. And we talked about a lot of things to address it. And yet, what are we doing to keep our mindset sharp? Because if not bold pivot, what are you going to do? It's halfway through the year. And if you know that, if you follow sports and you're a fan of sports, and I don't know, we might have talked about this, what happens, Jason, when your fatigue goes?
Your performance starts lacking. You get sloppy.
Right, you get sloppy. Your mindset goes, and your mindset goes, your actions follow. How are we making sure that our energies are protected and our mindsets are up there? Because if you're a leader, all of us are leaders. We're leaders in our families. We're leaders in our household. We're leaders to our SOIs and our database. How are we doing? So I would ask you to sign up for Bold Pivot because, again, if you talked about it and you said, man, I could do better at, you know, here's like even just a database plan. What am I going to send our people 36 times a year? We have a conversation about that in Bold. By the way, it's not going to, oh, I've been to Bold already. If we talked about self-mastery and eating the veggies first and being at peace with repetitious boredom, then you know that you only get about 10% of anything that you go into the first time anyway. So if you've been through Bold, you only got 10% of it. Guess what? Gary Keller says go 10 times because he knows that you only get 10% every single time for you to master the session, master your mindset, master the activities that it takes for us to be successful. So we're in Bold Pivot. So I trust that you get access to it, you get signed up for it, and here's what's going to be different. We're going to get some of our top people, our top agents, to zoom in with us and have conversations with the thousands of people who are going to be in Bold Pivot. We have a Market Center startup kit for accountability that's going to be offered as well. We got obviously Gary Keller jumping back in again, and also we got Coach's Corner right now happening. So if you could use a mindset shift as well as some coaching happening right now every Wednesday. Actually, matter of fact, we got Coach's Corner happening right now every single Wednesday from 11 to 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, then there you go. I mean, we've got the recipe for success. It's just now about go out there and doing. So with that being said, I just wanted to offer a quick little deliverable there. If you go to bigrealestatebusiness.com, obviously I make this offer as a, I'm sure that you're a shoe in for Bold if you've heard this message, because you know that you could use that jumpstart, that pick me up and that energy to keep moving forward and that focus. And you know, when you go to bigrealestatebusiness.com and give me a survey on how I did today, I'm going to send you a checklist for how I move my transactions through from both buyers and sellers, and over a 70 itemized list of how I create a repeatable and duplicated system that my clients continue to refer me for. So I'll give you that. I'll also give you a video on how to set your opportunities up to work with the checklist and monetize your pipeline for that year that you're forecasting your business, right? Forecast your business and your income and your commission a year out. 9 months out, 60 days out, 30 days out, right? We'll give you the ability to do that on top of a smart plan to help you convert all the 80-cent leads that you're getting by using command and generating your business through command as well. So you'll get those three items, bigrealestatebusiness.com. I am done. Jason, ahas, anybody out there, ahas, questions, concerns, hallucinations, grievances, I am here to air them all out. Let's talk.
Hit us up, guys. Carly saying awesome. Thanks. I mean, it was really awesome. We got it streaming into our group here. So I made sure I put the link to that in the group Facebook stream, as well as one of the things I put in here is that your energy and passion are just infectious. I'm like ready to run through a wall.
Let's do it.
I text Jason. I'm like, I love his energy. I'm like, no wonder you can fall in love with real estate again. You have amazing energy and your passion for what you're saying. And I loved at the beginning where they're just, you know, quick, easy tips that, yeah, we've heard before, but it's a great reminder how you you know, some of the old things we used to do at a license 22 years don't work anymore. And it's kind of like fashion. They come back around. So we know that, or it's old school stuff that we put the new school spin on, right? And that's what that did for me. It just reminded me, boy, these are simple niches that people can really go back to. And they may be more powerful now than they were a decade ago.
Oh, that's so good.
For the last 10 years, because the market had shifted and now it's shifted a different direction. So I appreciate that.
Right on. Thank you so much. Thank you for your participation today, Nikki. Appreciate you.
Absolutely.
What other ahas do y'all have? Reminders. Sometimes an aha is a reminder. I think we often think that aha means it's something new I've never heard before, but aha can most often is a reminder. Yeah, I need to do that. Mm-hmm. So what do you guys got?
Hey, no biggie. My biggest thing is help me out with those surveys so I can get you those smart plans that we talked about. And I've got to run on the next session. And Jason, I know you got another action-packed part to your meeting today. And so number one, I'm grateful, man. Thank you for your leadership and the opportunity to share with your group. I trust this is beneficial. You know, I've been hearing a lot of great things, and let's keep it going. Let's keep paying it forward. We got people to represent in our families, our households that we're leaders for. Leadership is at a premium right now. Don't stop, because mind share now is market share later.
Yes.
Right? The spoils will go to the folks who did not stop. And it's okay if you're tired. So lean in and grow your tank and reach deep and keep going.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you so much, Brian. Awesome stuff. Awesome. Okay. Awesome. Thank you for being here with us. All right, everybody, we are going to jump into our recognition portion of the meeting. So hopefully, was that good? Did you guys like that? Did you get value from that?
Yes, sir.
Wonderful. Wonderful. All right, I'm going to share my screen here, and let's keep that conversation going. Let's not let the conversation die from, you know, Brian finished and that's it. No, let's keep that conversation going. Let's live our passion here. All right. First thing I want to make sure is I want to reiterate what he was talking about. That bold pivot is ready for registration. Now, if you did bold pivot before and you're like, I didn't quite get what I wanted out of bold pivot, or, you know, I'm not ready for another, race riot in the comments. It's not going to be like that this time, okay? Recognize that when they did bold pivot that first time, that was a quick on-the-fly pivot to how can we still deliver value, and they learned a lot. So this round of bold pivot is going to be even better than last time. It's going to be more purposeful for us. They've learned ways to that they heard from feedback as to what would make things better. And my guys and gals,
KW.
It's KW stuff. It's $99. You're not going to find better learning out there for $99. It's just not. And because it'll be in there, you can come back, watch the stuff. I strongly still recommend you be in bold. Those who are in bold from last session, this is the data they were able to collect. So this is just also based on people who were using command, because recognize that's where they got most of this data for, was based on people who were using command. All right. So those who attended versus who didn't attend, 79% more smart plans were created. They had 9% more contracts written. Remember, bold pivot was a month. So in a month, there was 9% more contracts written. 14% more listings were taken, 39% more opportunities, 46% more contacts, and 133% more campaigns created.
Huge.
That's big deal right there, okay? So get in there, the $99. As far as, you know, from the Market Center, go get signed up. We're going to work out some sort of stimulus for you guys. We always do. Know that that's coming, and it will be retroactively applied, of course. If you've signed up, you know, the kind of thing where you get a closing, then you can get reimbursed. We're going to have something like that. So get planned beyond there. All right. Also, our region is helping you get up and running in command. They have this course, it's running three times. It's not building on each other. It's the same course. The first one was last week. The second one is today, immediately following this. And then they're doing it again next week on the 23rd. Okay, it's a two-hour class, and they're going over opportunities, the consumer app, designs, campaigns, and contacts, you know, connecting your contacts and smart plans. So these are tech drivers in the different market centers that are teaching these classes. The link for this is on KWEV Dates. This is on there for KWEV Dates. So just go on there and you can click and join the Zoom meeting. Okay. Good stuff. Also, don't forget about the command challenge. There's a playlist for all the past ones on our YouTube channel. So you can go back and get caught up, go back and rewatch the ones that we've done, all that kind of stuff. Folks, utilize command. I'm going to even say, don't buy into all the, if you're hearing Schmack talk about it, get in there and figure out the people that are having trouble with it. It's because they haven't taken the time to even learn it and use it in the way that it's intended. Is there still stuff to come? Yes. There's going to always be stuff to come. That's the beautiful thing about command, is it will never be finished. Tomorrow, free CE class on Zoom. That means you can like be having lunch, or you can be, you know, doing other work or negotiating something while it's on. You don't have to be sitting there in the class. So maybe I didn't say that out loud. And here it is. From 1 to 4, it's no cost to you. Ramon's putting it on. Mark Windsor is teaching us about fair housing. I know it's a super exciting topic, but it's one of the required ones you have to have for your renewal hours. So tomorrow, 1 to 4, Zoom link is on KWEV Dates, fair housing. Okay. And want to give a big thank you to Stacy Williams with Guild Mortgage, who is our sponsor for today. Stacy, are you on in a place? He's had some consultation stuff going on. So Stacy, if you're on in a place, I'd like to throw it over to you.
He's here.
Yeah. Hey guys, yeah, I've been tied up in a consultation. As you know, everybody's just looking to buy and refinance, and it's just been really wild. But obviously, if you have clients, this is the time. I was just quoting interest rates on 30-year fixed, 2.625, 30-year fixed with 1% origination on a conventional.
How much? What was that?
2.625.
Stacy, I may need you to refinance my house. I just,
right? Yeah, it's out of control right now, guys. I mean, rates are, I've been in the industry obviously 15 years now, and this is the lowest I've seen rates.
Holy hell, I've been doing this 22 years.
Talk, I've never seen that.
What was that, guys?
22 years, I've never heard 2.7, honestly, ever.
Yeah, and these are 30-year fixed, guys, just to make sure I'm clear. 15-year rates are pretty low as well, but not too much lower than the 30-year.
So think about this as a touch to your guys' database, folks. I mean, your database own houses, and they don't have an interest rate this low, because this is a new historic low. I mean, it wasn't more than maybe a month ago we were saying, okay, rates might be coming down, but we'll never see them as low as we did before. It went below it.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah. And so I think a lot of lenders are still really busy with refinances, but I think some of that volume is tailing off. So we hope to see turn times for purchases as well as refis tighten up a little bit. But right now, guys, if you're out there writing offers, I know a short close of escrow is a way to try to win the deal, but Keep that in mind. It might take 30 days to get through a transaction.
Yep.
Good way to make sure you're setting the right expectations.
That's right.
For sure.
So, Stacy, thank you for always the support that you bring to our office, and the value you have, and the availability you provide, and just always being a partner for us. So, really, thank you.
All right, guys. Thank you very much. I love being a part of KW. I'm here if you need me.
Awesome. Thank you, Stacy.
All right, guys. We'll see you.
Holy crap, we may need to be refinancing.
Right? God, guys, 2.67. That's
I got two houses, but that's lower than both.
Yeah, that's insane.
Yeah,
get out there. Yep, see? And if you're reaching out, that's a perfect way to reach out to your sphere and say, hey, look, I'm doing this too. Who wants to come with me? Let me get you connected,
this
right?
That's crazy.
Wow. All right. New associates who joined us in June. We had 6 new agents become part of our KWEV family. If you see them around, we will be posting here soon. We're going to start having a board. We have a board already purchased. We're going to be hanging it up that will have all the information for our new associates here in the office. So if any of you forgot where the office is, you know, feel free to drop it in the chat. I'll give you back the email address. I mean, the physical address, because it's been so long, right? I'll remind you where it's at. It's no problem. And you're going to start seeing pictures and more information about these people come up, because we want you to know who they are and integrate them into our KWEV family. So as you see them around, if you hear their names, Nicole, Lori, Anton, John, Chandler, and Barry, give them a big KWEV welcome, okay? As you guys always do. Listings taken in June, okay? This is something I want us to really have more of a focus on, and you're going to hear me talking about. In fact, I'm going to be putting together a panel for the last Wednesday of this month around getting your listings, okay? Because we need to be very listing focused. But Jason, there's no listings out there. That's part of the point, okay? You need, this is the time to be go getting your unfair share. And those who are putting in some work focused on listings, they're reaping the rewards, all right? So in our individual units, we see Josh and Katie both with three individual listings taken. Amy Nelson had two, along with Chelsea, Jill, Eddie, Katie Walsh, and Kathy Melvin. Congratulations, y'all. Good job. Teams, Valley Home Pros, Josh Randall's group, they had three. The Maria Teresa Anderson team took four. So that seems like it's backwards. So just kind of tilt your head when you read that one. And the Tom Wood team had two. Good job. For our groups, Carol Royce, she took 25 listings, guys. But there's no listings out there. Carol Royce took 25 listings. Guess what? She took 25 listings last month, too. Well, then she didn't go up. Well, if the number of listings is going down and she took the same amount, her market share is what's increasing.
Mm-hmm.
That's a perfect example. I mean, when you want to look at an agent in our market who understands how to take advantage of a shift, man, watch what Carol does, okay? She knows how to take advantage of a shift. She doesn't get, she's not a one-trick pony. She says, all right, in this shift, what do I have to do? She's gotten very purposeful and tactful on her listings, even more so than she was before. Yes, there are still things she could adjust. And getting 25 last month and 25 this month shows, even though she maintained in terms of the level exactly where she's at, she has garnered more market share. Impressive, very impressive. Okay, the Home Coach team took seven, Olmstead team got six, Shanna Day five, and Desert Pinion Partners, congratulations. Showing up, three listings taken in June for the group. Good job. Listings taken volume. We see the volume of these listings that can happen. Katie Evans, nearly a million. Jill Rother, 730. Eddie, 719. Josh, Joshua Kreitz with 713. Good job, man. Amy Nelson, 704. Chelsea Anderson, 675. Katie Walsh, 645. And Kathy Melvin, 627. Our teams, Valley Home Pros, 884,000. The Miller team, good job, Susan, 775. Maria Teresa Anderson, 719. Tom Wood, 600. And the Gold Group, breaking the 500 barrier with 539. Listings taken volume for groups. Carol Royce, just over 11 million in a single month. Jeez. Just let that sink
in. Shake her head.
Just let that sink in for a second. Matt Coaches and the Home Coach group team, 3 million, just over 3 million. Bill Olmstead and his team, 1.7. Desert Pinion as well, 1.7. Shanna Day, nearly 1.6. And that luxury group showing up, breaking the $1 million mark. Good job. Everybody out there. Getting out there and getting after the business that can be had. Closed volume. Cynthia Worley, individual agent, nearly broke the $3 million mark on her own last month. Cynthia. Phenomenal job. Congratulations to you. It's really, really, really good job. Amy Nelson nearly hit 1.7 at 1.668. Katie Walsh just below the 1.6 mark, 1.59. Nikki Jackson, congratulations on a great month, Nikki. 1.3, nearly 1.4 in the month. So congratulations, Nikki. Michael Hernandez, just shy of 1.3 million. Brooke Bogart, 1.2 million, and Scott Graff, attaboy, breaking the $1 million mark with 1.1. Our teams, Valley Home Pros, Josh Randall and his team, 3.7 million. Keller Gibbs, breaking the $2 million mark. Way to go, girls. Tom Wood, 1.6. Miller team, nearly 3. And the Kelserson group, 1.2, just shy of 1.2. Great job, everyone. Closed volume for our groups. Carol closed 16. The Carol Royce team is 16, over 16 million in June. Matt Cochis, 6.7. Olmsted team, 5.2 million. Shanna Day, just shy of the $5 million mark. The home selling team of Randy and Janine, busting the $4 million barrier. And the Green Group, selling over $3 million last month. Good job. Hey. I mean, something we know how to do here at KWEV. We know how to move some properties. Let me just tell you that. We know how to move some properties. We right now, guys, in terms of units sold, we are right about 2% of the entire Phoenix market is our market share. That's pretty darn impressive. Total units closed in July. Cynthia had 5 for her, huge month of, I already forgot, 3.5 million or whatever she did. Amy Nielsen, 4. Brooke Bogart, 4. Katie Walsh, 4. And Michael Hernandez, also 4. Good month, everybody. Good month to you all. Our teams, Josh Randall in the Valley Home Pros, 11 units for his team. The Keller Gibbs team, 6. Tom Wood, 4. Miller team, 4. And the Kelson groups, 4 as well. So everybody, great job. As for our groups for units, Carol closed out 35. Home coach team, 16.6. It was they had an issue with that house. It kind of like, I don't know, it was burned down, so only 1/4 of it or so. I don't know. In terms of how Keller counts them, technically it's 17, but just how Keller does it, that's why it's a 6, if you're wondering why is there a 6 there. Olmsted team, 14. Home selling team of Randy and Janine, 11. And Shanna Day, 8 units closed. So everybody, good job. We will be putting out the poster today with all the breakdowns of everything. We'll be around in the office, and I'll be posting it on social media. So feel free to share it, recognize yourself, give yourself a pat on the back. Everybody, wonderful, wonderful job. Broker Mike in the house. And we're going to kick it over to you, Broker Mike, for our Broker Minute.
Hey, guys. How's it going? Just a few things I want to update you on today. Sorry I got here late, but I was just helping somebody write their first contract in command. So that was exciting. Number one, I want to remind you about the CE class tomorrow. 1 to 4, Ramon from AmeriFirst is the one that's arranged this for us. And you guys, if you haven't taken CE classes with this new format yet, it is awesome because you're doing it by Zoom. You're not taking a bunch of tests like you do in online CE classes. You're just attending it through Zoom. It's super easy. You're doing it from home. I did the last class and I was just thrilled with how great it was. You're getting that in-class experience of discussion, and you're not going through all the hassle of doing an online class. So you definitely want to do this. You should be getting a text on this today. Don't forget, you do need to sign up for it in advance if you want to get CE credit. So sign up for it through the text, or later this afternoon, I'll also be sending out an email on it. So I want to make sure you guys are doing that. Number two, reminder about the purchase contract, page 10. Something that I've seen multiple times lately is when we have a dual agency transaction, the agents are still checking, representing buyer on line 450 and representing seller on line 464. If you take a look at the wording there, it's asking who the brokerage is, not who the agent is. It's an agency confirmation, but it's for the brokerage. So make sure you're checking the box that says both buyer and seller on 450 and 464 on page 10 of the purchase contract. And then the third thing I want to hit today, and I hope you guys know this about me, I'm open book. We make a mistake, we own it, and we fix it. That's just the bottom line anytime there's an error. And we had an error recently in the market center. One of our agents put up a new website and they did not get the full company name up in the upper left-hand corner. You guys, that is an advertising violation. We got a letter from the ADRE this week about this advertising violation. And I wanted to share that with everybody as a reminder. This is advertising is not just business cards and yard signs and flyers. It's your websites too. And anytime you guys make a change to your website or bring a new website online, you've got to give me a chance to approve it for compliance, okay? In this case, it's an oversight on the agent's part. These things happen, I understand that. I'm not bringing this up to embarrass anybody. I'm bringing it up because we all want to learn from others' experience. And in this case, the experience is we forgot to submit it for review and we put out something that was not compliant. So a reminder to everybody, if I have not seen your website yet, give me a chance to approve it for compliance. All you have to do, excuse me, is email me with a link to the homepage of the website. I'll look through it and let you know if it's approved or not. And then I also keep track of that on a spreadsheet on who has what website. So do me a favor, guys. Let's do an internal audit on this and let's make sure all of our websites are good. Okay. Thank you. Thanks, Jason. I appreciate it.
Wonderful. Thank you, Mike. And guys, that also extends to your social media. So make sure you're in compliance with your social media advertisements as well. Your Facebook page, if you're using your personal page, your personal profile, because you don't have a Facebook page, then each of your posts needs to make sure you're staying compliant. So make sure you're aware of those rules as well, because they can get you in trouble just as easily. So good reminders. And guys, we're supposed to have Mike sign off on those things anyway. So a great way to keep yourself out of trouble when having something like that is to make sure you run it by Broker Mike. Thanks, Mike. All right, our June Home Run Awards. Okay. These are the folks in the that took a listing, they had a closing, they wrote a contract, they rounded the bases, they, you know, people cheered, that kind of thing. All right, Tom Wood, Amy Nelson, Asia Coleman, Brad and Mindy Fawcett, Brooke Bogart, Carol Royce, Chelsea Anderson, good job, Chelsea. Cynthia Worley, Doug Royce, attaboy Doug and Ryan, Eddie Robles, Honey, Jason and Chris, Jason Wells and Chris Niederhauser, Josh Randall, Joshua Kreitz, Casey Tejan, Karen Johnson, and Courtney Schaefer Gordon, Kathy Melvin, Katie Walsh, Len Saavedra, Matt Cochis, Penny Golden, Shannon Bowles, Sean Wynn and Kella Fan, Shanna Day, and Susan and Grant Miller. Congratulations, everybody. That's fantastic. June Cappers. All right. We had a significant number of people capping this month, everyone. Hani, Aaron, Armstrong, Marcus Bacon, Joshua Collum, Solange Fidel, which goes right along with Dennis, Carly Gibbs, Molly Gorman, Marcus Green, Eddie Hatcher, Matt Cochis, Susan Miller, Lindsay Sullivan, Jason Wells, Jeff Wood, Cynthia Worley, Mark Wyant, Robert Thompson, Katie Walsh, and Chris Niederhauser. Congratulations, everybody, on a great prior 12 months and being able to cap and now enjoying 100% of your commissions. Shout out to our first closings. Alyssa Eddy, $192,000 closing, and Jill Gifford, $430,000 closings. Congratulations, both of you, on your first of what we expect to be many closings. Really, really great job. Birthdays. Andre Surkoff, Kimberly Dorsey, Darlene Prentke, Sherry Bader, Chris Owen, PJ Stratford, Nicole Picas, Marlo Quast, John Perkins, we got Shawnee Moore, Josh Cullum, Judy McCullough on the 21st. Claudia Alvarez, Carol Turpin, David Klein, Garo, I'm going to butcher your last name there, Yalin Kantian. Garo, we're just going to call him G. Jessica Morrell and Vinny. Also not on the list on the 25th is Stephanie Ochoa's birthday. So happy birthday, everybody, here in July. And for our anniversaries, those who are celebrating an anniversary with KW, Jessica Adelaimi, 2 years, Michael Vickford, 2 years. Brooke Bogart hitting the 5-year mark. Congratulations, Brooke. David Klein, 2 years. Heidi, it's your first year. Congratulations. One full year in with the family. Matt Coaches, 3 years. Lorraine, 7. Dorian, 7. Casey Tejan, 3. Daniel Williams, 7. So what do some of these numbers mean? Well, those the 3-year marks for both Matt and Casey means you are now vested with Keller Williams because you've been in for the 3 years. At those of you who have joined more recently, the vesting period has become a little bit longer, but they were prior to that, so their vesting period is a 3-year period. So congratulations on vesting with your profit share. Also, those of you who had your 2-year mark, I have a 1-year pin for you because you didn't get a 1-year pin. If you didn't get a 1-year pin, I've got a 1-year pin for you, Jessica, Michael, and David. So come and see me or John Hollis. We have a 1-year pin for you. And Brooke, for 5 years, we have a 5-year pin for you. Congratulations. Congratulations. All right. So everybody, any thoughts, anything you want to bring up? Well, we had a pretty darn good June. Things looked good. We expected that in terms of how the market was going, that June would be a fairly good month for us. We're now looking at July's numbers. They're looking pretty healthy as well. That's because you guys are doing the work. So congratulations and good job with that. I want to encourage you to continue it. Anything that needs you want to bring up or have questions or address here now before we disband?
Quick announcement.
Please, Charles.
So Tech Enabled Agent on Friday, I'll be covering Steph Levine's It's All About You form and putting it into a landing page that you can send to your entire database so you can connect at a deeper level with your database via command. So please join me for that. Love to see you.
Awesome. That's Be the Tech Enabled Agent on Friday, 1 o'clock, everybody. Excellent. Thank you, Charles. We have the ALC meeting today at 3:30. That will be on Zoom. The ALC meeting is, you know, your board of directors. You are all free to jump in, listen, and see what we have going on. We are talking about some stuff for this next year. I want us all, so you know, little spoiler alert, we need to be much more focused on the listings. I talked about that a little bit with Brian. So we're going to be looking to bring you more listing resources, more listing campaigns, listing ideas, listings. Did I mention listings? I didn't. There you go. All right. Any other things? Anybody else? Broker Mike, you have something?
Yeah, listings.
Listings. Good. I'll get a great idea. I'm writing it down. All right, everybody. Thank you so much for being here, for making KWEV truly the best brokerage in the Valley and in the West and soon to be in the country. So get out there. Let's keep killing it. Be safe. Be strong. All right, everybody. Be safe. Be strong. Onward together, everyone. Thank you. We should have some music playing.
Night, we'll take a walk. It's nothing funny, just to